بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. So inshallah today moving on to the إعراب محلي. And under إعراب محلي we have اسم المؤول, we have الاسم المشتغل إعرابه بإعراب لفظي, and then we have المبني. So we have الباب الأول في الاسم, then we have المقدمة إعراب لفظي, إعراب تقديري, إعراب محلي, and the خاتمة in إعراب لفظي we have إعراب بالحركة, then we have إعراب بالحرف. And the تقديري, there was no like specific clarifications on that one. And then here we have الاسم المؤول, الاسم المعرب, المشتغل آخره بإعراب لفظي, and then we also have الاسم المبني. So these are the three. This is complete. This is complete. No discussion in here. And now we're going to discuss these three each in a separate lesson, inshallah. Everyone following? Okay. بسم الله. الفصل الثالث في إعراب الاسم المحلي. We know إعراب محلي. We explained what إعراب محلي was already. وهو ثلاثة أنواع. There are three types of إعراب محلي. النوع الأول الاسم المؤول نحو أريد أن أسافر إلى مكة كي أحج. Okay. Now here. We've done it before in Surah, been explained, but just a recap. And ism al-ma'awwal is what? What is it? Harfu masdar plus the jumla after it. Correct? The jumla, which is made usually jumla ismiya, jumla fa'liya, usually fa'liya. So ism al-ma'awwal is what? Awwala yu'awwilu ta'wil, to reinterpret something. So even though the harf masdar is a harf and the jumla is a jumla, we put them together and we consider them. So ism al-ma'awwal, that which is not necessarily by essence and a noun, but but we understand it to be a noun. For example, أُرِيدُ أَنْ أُسَافِرَ إِلَى مَكَّةَ كَيْ أَحُجَّ. So what do we have in here? We have فعل فاعل. That is harf masdar. This harf masdar وما بعدها. This is an ism al-ma'awwal. Why is ism al-ma'awwal? Because we have the harf masdar of أن plus the jumla after it. And then this is treated like a noun. This is like an ism. What is it becoming? Maf'oolun bihi of the uridu. Does everybody understand this? There is an i'rab and tarkib many times, but this is summarized. And then we also have another harf masdar. So you have, this is also an ism ma'awwal. You can change the color here. This is also an ism ma'awwal. Why? This is also an ism ma'awwal. Why? It has a harf masdar, kay, plus the jumla after it. And then this is treated as an ism. What it become? Why do you want to travel to Mecca? مفعول له, the reason. مفعول له. مفعول له غير صريح. Or is it مفعول له غير? I don't know if it's صريح or غير صريح. But it is غير صريح. Okay? Do you understand? Are you following? Yes? Any question regarding this? This came before. It came in the Arabic book. It came in the surah. Just a quick recap. Yes? So an ism المؤول also is إعراب محلي. How is it إعراب محلي? Because this can't have an إعراب, this is a harf. This has an إعراب because of an, this is مبني, this has an إعراب because of this, this has an إعراب. But what will happen? We will say, overall, we will assume this whole jumla to be منسوب محلن. Why is it منسوب محلن? Because it's a مفعول به. So the إعراب is محلن. It's in a slot of the أريد. Similarly, this is also going to be منسوب محلن. Why? It's in a slot of the maf'ul lahu. Understood? Is everybody understand al-ism al-ma'awwal? So the harf al-masdar and the noun after it's called an ism al-ma'awwal. For example, now the i'rab of this. أُرِيدُ أَنْ أَسَافِرَ إِلَى مَكَّةَ. The first parts are easy. And this has come before as well, but let's just recap it again. So an, you say an is harf al-masdar. It's mabni al-sukoon. Correct? Then we have أسافر is فعل مضارع منسوب بالفتحة because أن is also حرف مصدر and is عامل as well. So it makes the word after it منسوب. And then أنا ضمير مستتر فاعل مرفوع محلا instead of أسافر. إلى حرف جر مبني للسكون مكة مجرور بالفتحة. So that's one حرف مصدر. So this is one حرف مصدر. And then وشبه الجملة وشبه الجملة إلى مكة إذ مفعول فيه غير صريح منسوب محلا. Correct? Anybody following? Then كاي is harf masdar. Again, another harf masdar. مبنين على السكون. أنا أحج فعل مضارع منسوب بالفتحة. أنا زي مستتر فاعل مرفوع محلا. And then we say here. وكاي وما بعدها اسم المؤول. كاي, the harf masdar. What is after it? The كاي is harf masdar. And the word after it, the jumla after it, is ismun ma'awwal, is understood or treated as an ism. And this becomes the maf'ul lahu of usafir. And then, that's maf'ul lahu of usafir. And then the an, wa ma ba'da, is also ism ma'awwal. That's a maf'ul bihi of uridu. And this example that has come previously in the Arab section. Does everybody understand? Everyone following? Any questions regarding this? Okay. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayka.